Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Talk Time. You know, today I'm going to do a lot of referencing of my grandfather, aka G-Pop Austin. Let me quickly tell you a story that happened with him and I just recently, just maybe a week or two ago. I walked in the house, and my grandfather, he sits in the family room because he can no longer physically walk. So he greets us all in his chair in the family room area. And soon as I walked in the door, he was like, T. And he points at me and he says, you come sit over here by me. So I went and sat by him and he says, hey, let me borrow $5,000. And I says, well, G-Pop, if I had it, I'd just give it to you. And he laughs. He says, I know you will. And he says, you know what? Pretty soon I'll be able to say that to you. And I just kind of laugh and put my head down. I'm like, well, we'll see. And he says, girl, I'm looking at you and you do not know your worth and value. You don't know, do you? And I'm thinking, I kind of know. And, you know, at that point, I realized that he wasn't just saying, Tania, because he watches my shows, and he wasn't just saying, Tania, go for your dreams. You can make a lot of money. You can do this thing, which that was one part of what he was saying. But the main part of what he was saying was, did I really know how valuable I was on the inside? Did I really know who I was and how God created me? And he also told me, he said, T, you be careful not to get in your own way. Don't get in your own way of walking in the fullness of all that God has for you. And I'm telling you, that has just stirred in me ever since him and I had that conversation. And I know that I'm probably not the only one. I know that there's many others out there that don't know their worth and value. And sometimes it's because they just simply don't know. They just don't have the knowledge of it. Or they don't know how God originally created them. Or sometimes there's bondage and we are bounded down by ourselves, our thinking, the enemy, or sometimes the labels and things that people place upon us. And we just got to remember that we can't always dwell on the bad or the negative. Sometimes we need some correction. So some of the negative things need to come out. But the most important thing is to honor the beauty that God has placed in us. And we can't always just point out the bad, you know, or allow people to point out the bad in us. Let me show you an example. My grandfather also used to do this example with us as a family. He used to gather all of us kids, us grandkids, whoever was around who could hear his voice. He used to be like, you guys, come here. So we used to all come and sit by his feet. And he used to get a paper towel. And he used to do this right here. He'd tear off a corner. And he'd say, you guys, look at this paper towel. Now you tell me, what's outstanding about this paper towel? And of course, everybody used to be, well, G-Pop, you just tore off a corner. There's a corner missing. And he'd be like, nope, that's not what's outstanding. What's outstanding about this piece of paper is that it has three perfect corners on it still. That's the beauty of knowing and seeing things the way God sees them. God don't look at us with our negativity or the things that's wrong with us. He doesn't look at that at all. He looks at the great things that he's placed in us. And you know, I just want to make sure that we're looking at ourselves this way and we're looking at others this way as well, knowing our worth and knowing other people's worth and treating them as such. You know, I was reminded when I was putting this message together that there was an Aglo message. My friend and I, Miss Glenda, we did a video message on worth and value. And I thought, you know what? I'm going to show my friends that message because it goes right along with what I'm talking about today. So if you got a quick moment, just take a look.
Hello, I am Glenda Clark.
And I'm Tania Benson.
And we are your Community Lighthouse leaders from Mount Pleasant, Michigan.
And we have an encouraging word on worth and value today.
Do you know that you are far more worth, your value is far more worth than rubies?
And so many people upon the earth, they men and women, they don't know their value. They don't know the true worth that God has placed upon our lives.
You know, some walk around defeated, lost. They're wearing labels and name tags like you're stupid, you're ignorant.
Yeah. And sometimes even though we take on those labels and titles and we may be torn on the inside, that never changes our true worth and original design that God has for us. And I don't know if anybody remembers, but there was a video out there where this gentleman had $100 bill, and he took that $100 bill and he scrunched it up and tore it up a little bit. And then he unfolded it, and he might have had to put a little bit of tape on it, but it never changed the value of that $100 bill. The same goes with us, friends.
Friends, know that you are worthy of love and affection.
Know that you are never too much, but always enough.
And you are fearfully and wonderfully made.
Know that you are the most stunning of all God's creation.
Please just remember this.
All right, Aglow family. We love you and know your worth and value. I'm Tania Benson.
And I'm Glenda Clark.
So, did you watch the video? Did it bless you? I know it blessed me doing the message. Just putting that message together with her was so powerful to me, especially the part about the $100 bill and how it still had its value, even though it had been beat up and torn. My friends, that is us. That is us. We need to remember and we need to know that we are God's masterpiece, and He has given us a royal identity. We don't want to be just standing outside our royal castle, wishing that we could live there or just getting a glimpse of what it's like on the inside. Friends, know that we can be on the inside. Know that God has given us keys. He's given us access. And once we understand our royal identity and all the greatness and all the wonderful things, because the Bible says that He knows our inner parts, we are fearfully, wonderfully made, and we're His masterpiece. And there's so many other beautiful scriptures in there that defines who we are in Christ. But let me tell you, once we know and we understand who we are, we can live here. We can live here. And I don't want you to think that, you know, if you have a castle like this in the physical, you know, physically, if you living in a place like that, I don't want you to think that just because you may be wealthy, that defines your identity, that validates who you are, because it doesn't. It really doesn't. I'm speaking spiritually here. Now, don't hear me wrong. Now, if you happen to be able to purchase a place like this, live and be wonderfully blessed by that, because God wants good for His people. But I'm speaking spiritually. I don't want us to go through life not walking in the fullness of what God has for us, not knowing who we are. And once you know who you are, you help others to find that same validation, that same identity that He originally created us to be. In closing, friends, this is what I want to say. You may not be awesome according to the world's labels and standards, but you are amazing simply because you are made in the image of God. And let me tell you something. This isn't just for women. This is for men too. So men, right now, I say you rise in the name of Jesus, because you are created for greatness. You were created for greatness. Stand a little taller today, knowing that you are created in the image of God. Women, you rise today in the name of Jesus, knowing who you are. You are life givers. You are created to help mankind. I call you blessed in the name of Jesus. Thank you so much for watching Talk Time. I want to dedicate this show to my grandfather, the brilliant man named Joseph Banks Austin Sr. G-Pop, I love you. Thank you for always believing in me. Thank you for depositing your wisdom. And when God spoke to you to speak to me, and all the things that you've deposited in me, all the things you've just given to me for my journey, I thank you so much. And because of you and God, there truly is amazing things about to happen. I love you all. And I love my G-Pop. Thank you so much for watching Talk Time. God bless you. Know your worth and value. Amen.